Welcome to Lesson 4 in Homebrew Audio's Newbie's Guide to Audio Recording Awesomeness, Volume 2. Today we're going to start talking about voiceover recording tips. We have a bunch of those to come. Today we'll talk about how to split one audio item into many using a tool called Auto Trim Split in Reaper. In Lesson 3, you used your upgraded home studio to produce your audio by rendering or mixing down multiple files to one file. We rendered directly to WAV format, and in doing that, transitioned from 24-bit recording to 16-bit recording so that players like Windows Media Player would be able to play the results when it was done, because these media players do not recognize 24-bit. We also rendered directly to MP3 format, and in order to do that, we downloaded and installed the MP3 LAME encoder first, just like we had to do in Audacity in Module 1. Today, we'll start learning about some tools that will save you lots of time and effort in the studio, starting with a tool called Auto Trim Split, which can split a single audio item into many at the press of a button. This is great for certain types of voiceover gigs, especially conversations, but it's also useful for music recording or any other type of recording that you plan to do, just like all of these tips we're going to talk about. All right, let's start by opening Reaper. Here's Reaper. You should be familiar with it by now. So this tool is going to be great for certain types of voiceover jobs. If you do voiceover recording, you're going to eventually run into a job that requires you to save one long audio file into several small audio files, and each of those smaller files has to be named. This can be really tedious. The kind of job that requires this is either recording a conversation. I have to do a lot of those for English as a second language type programs. Or a lot of e-learning programs require a separate audio file for each slide if it's going to be a slide presentation, such as a PowerPoint presentation or so on. So what we're going to do here is record a sample script, something similar to what you might see. And first we'll do it the hard way, the way that I started out and most people start out doing this. And then I'll show you the automated way to use the Auto Trim Split tool to make this job much, much easier. Okay, so let's open a track. Come over here and double-click in this space. And you should already have your mic set up, ready to go. So just go ahead and click in there. I'm just going to record some things I wrote down that are similar to jobs that I've done. Ready? Here we go. I'm going to press the record button. To catch on means to understand. To float an idea means proposing an idea. Run the numbers means to evaluate something. To run amok means to proceed with no plan. All right, so we just go ahead and save that. You'll see that it's all in one file. And as we zoom out, we see we've got four distinct sections of audio in this one item here. I have a voiceover recording client who produces ESL, English as a Second Language, e-learning podcasts, and often needs exercises recorded for the students to listen to, where the narrator reads a list of sentences or phrases. This client asks that there be exactly 3 seconds between each phrase. And this wouldn't be a big deal if it were only 3 or 4 phrases, like this here. I could just split the file and space them out manually, which I'm about to demonstrate. But usually there are more like 50 or 60 phrases or more, and the manual method then just becomes too tedious and too time-consuming. So here's how to do it manually. But before we start that, though, I want to mention something. The snapping tool right here. Reaper projects have snapping turned on by default, but for the kind of thing we'll be doing, we need more flexibility than snapping allows, so we're going to want to turn that off. By the way, you might be familiar with the idea of snapping from programs like PowerPoint or other graphic programs, where snapping items to a grid allows you to space things out evenly and align things more easily. In recording programs, the tool snaps the edges of audio items to the grid, whether that is set up for seconds and minutes or musical beats and bars. See, these little lines right here represent the grid, and you can see here that in Reaper, the default is to have it set up for both bars and beats and minutes and seconds, which is actually kind of cool. But anyway, here's kind of what would happen if I tried to slide this around in time. You see how it only slides in increments of the grid? I can't slide anywhere in between the grid because it's snapping to the grid. So we're going to want to turn this off so we can have more flexibility when we split and move things around. Now that that's off, I can drag it in between the grid points there so I can have more control. Okay, so the first thing we're going to want to do is split and sort of trim these things down. The way that you sort of trim things is, remember we talked about this in lesson two, you just drag the end of an item, hover over it until you get this icon, and then click the left mouse button, hold it down, and drag it until just before you see the audio start. And now we're going to want to split in Reaper. That's just hitting the S key. So now we've split this off to be its own little phrase. We're going to hover over the end edge of the item here now and drag that in. And there we go. Now we've got one phrase that is its own audio item. Now we're going to do the same with the rest. So drag this to the beginning. Come over here. Hit the S key to split. Make sure that's trimmed, and so forth. We do this for each of the audio items. Now you can start to see, you know, with three or four, it's easy, but if you had to do this for 60 or 70 or whatever, it would be real tedious. Okay, now we've got four items, and we have a variable amount of space in between. What we're going to want to do, we'll have that start at zero. We want 3 seconds in between each one. I'm going to go ahead and change the display up here for the grid to just minutes and seconds. So we can, actually, let's just change it to seconds. That will help us to make sure that there's 3 seconds in between everything. 3, 4, 5, okay, so get it to where each increment is, actually it looks like 2 grid points now is 1 second. So this one stops at right about 3. So obviously we want this one to start at 6 if we want 3 seconds in between them. And ends at 10. So we want this one to 11, 12 to start at 13. And this one ends at about 16 and a half, so we want this to be at 19 and a half, and so on. So now, there we have it. 4 items that have been split and trimmed, and we've gone ahead and spaced them out by 3 seconds apiece. That was the manual method. So what I'm going to do is undo all of this. So now I've undone everything, and we have one file with the 4 blobs, the 4 little phrases in it right now. Okay, so what we're going to want to do is find the Auto Trim Split tool. This tool isn't very commonly used, so the way we find it is under the Actions menu up here. So click on Actions, go to the Show Actions list. See, we have to actually know this tool exists first. And put Auto Trim, and you can see right here we've got Auto Trim Split Items. So we're going to go ahead and click Run. And here are the default settings for Auto Trim Split. Don't worry about what any of them means for the moment. Just leave the default areas and hit Process. So now looking at what happened here, we can see it gave us more splits than we wanted. That's because it is set to read only a certain amount of silence between items. So what we want to do is increase that setting. So go ahead and let's undo this. That's this button right here. And I'm going to give you some settings to use for Auto Trim Split. These are the settings that I have experimented with and that I know work for a job like this. Let's go back to it through the Actions menu. What I'm going to do here is show you how to put it on your keyboard so you don't have to go through this Actions menu thing again. So auto trim split. I've got it set up for control accent. I think that is, it's the same key as the tilde key on my keyboard. But you can choose whatever keyboard combination you want. So let's just go down here real quick and let's delete what we have there. This is what yours will look like. So go ahead and click add and then just hold down your keyboard combination. I'm going to hold down my control and my accent slash tilde key here. Done, and then just click OK. So now let's close that and select your audio item and hit your keyboard shortcut, in my case, the control tilde key, and this is what comes up. Now, these are the settings that I find work well for me, so let's take a look at them and try these settings for your own. The threshold at negative 34.1 decibels. Hysteresis is zero. Ignore silence shorter than 800 milliseconds. Make non-silent clips no shorter than 200 milliseconds. Leading pad 3, trailing pad 100 milliseconds. Don't worry what these things all mean. Fade pad, leave the check mark there. Auto adjust snap offset 50 milliseconds. And then a check mark in preserve timing of non-silent areas. Try those settings and let's see how they work for you. Here's how they work for me. See, it didn't give us all those extra splits in the audio items. It split it to just the audio that I wanted. So that's a lot faster, isn't it, than having to manually go through and drag and then click the S key and drag back and click the S key again and drag and do all that. So that is how you use the Auto Trim Split tool. You'll find a lot of uses for this, especially if you have another character in another track that you have to edit a conversation for. So if you have this person speaking and then that person has to speak, etc., etc., using Auto Trim Split will allow you to drag each person's part of the conversation around, and then you can edit it however you want, making things a lot faster and a lot more flexible. In the next lesson, we'll continue with this example, and we'll show you how to put those 3 seconds in there using another tool in Reaper, and we'll also introduce you to ripple editing, which you can use for this and for many other things as well, another very useful tool. So we'll see you back here for lesson 5.